Justice Roberts was told you can't go to grad school, and so she said, fine, I'm going to go to law school, and she made a secondary career happen anyway. Judge Tennyson was similar. She was elected to the bench, which is a really rare path for somebody to find. Usually they're appointed by the governor and then retained in an election, but Judge Tennyson was like, this is the job for me. I'm gonna go out there and convince people of it, and she knocked doors and she was able to make it happen.
There's no generational barrier for Judge Tennyson. I mean, she just has this great ability to relate to anybody at any age.
The first generation group is so amazing, and I don't believe that people who are not first generation could ever fully understand how important that group is. We talk about what it's like to be the first in our family to be a professional.
She identifies needs and problems and then takes them on.
As seeing guardianships for elderly people, she saw a lot of people that weren't necessarily getting the care they needed. Again, she saw a hole. She looked at our juvenile system, and there's a program there called CASA, and those are court-appointed special advocates for kids. And she basically determined that our vulnerable elderly citizens needed something along those lines as well. And she went out in her Catherine way and pulled together an entire program.
She was really instrumental in sort of moving the Guardian Partners program along, and that is to be able to provide education to fiduciaries.
She is very involved in the National Council for Family and Juvenile Judges, and that's a national organization. Last year she was the president of that organization. She's been involved in that organization for years.
I'm very proud to represent the National Council of Juvenile and Family Court Judges in celebrating our past president, Judge Katherine Tennyson. She also prepared the National Council to expand the diversity and engagement of younger legal professionals and preparing for the judiciary.
There just weren't any qualified women or minorities. They just didn't exist. It was like unicorns. And, you know, we all knew that wasn't true. We all knew that qualified people were actually applying. They just weren't being perceived as qualified. And then the judicial work group began out of that.
And we were finding that it was difficult for women to get on the bench because we were told there were no women in the pipeline, which in 2000 seemed to be kind of an odd thing to say. So Justice Tennyson on the board was, what are we going to do about that? How are we going to get women in the pipeline? And from that evolved the road to the bench. It was her idea, and she is an idea person. And as she says, I get an idea and then I surround myself with women or other people who are going to participate in that.
She herself had run up against an old boys network, and she said, why don't we have an old girls network? Let's get on this problem of finding out ways to break through some of these barriers.
She changes the world every day when she sees needs in our community and makes sure that they're filled. She doesn't need a cape or a tiara. She's got her robe, and that's enough for her.
My one word for describing Judge Tennyson is she is real. She takes a really hard job and she makes it better every way that you can do that.
One word, it would be pragmatic.
Tenacious.
The quote is, it is neither preaching or praying that make a better person of me, but one or two people who believe in me more than I deserve, and I'd hate to disappoint them. And that is how I feel about Judge Tennyson's mentorship and sponsorship of all young professionals. Thank you, Judge Tennyson, and congratulations.